Hello and welcome. My name is Arun Nagarajan, and in this video tutorial, we'll talk about adding custom menus to Spreadsheet. So menus are the top bar where you're able to inject things like where you have file, edit, and whatnot. And in this tutorial, at the end of it, you'll be able to add your own custom menus to that bar. So let's get started. So you'll find this tutorial under the Intermediate Tutorials and Other Tutorials section. Just scroll down to the section called User Interfaces. Click on Defining Spreadsheet Menus, and that'll be all the code we'll need. It actually says 5 minutes, but it'll take a lot less than that. It's actually a very straightforward process, you'll see. So in order to do this, the first thing that you need to do is have a spreadsheet available. So for this demo, I'll start a new spreadsheet, but you can also use an existing spreadsheet if you have one. I'll just name this Custom Menus, and I need to open the script editor in the context of the spreadsheet. So in other demos, you may have seen us go to script.google.com directly and enter code there. But in this particular example, it's very important that the script is associated with the spreadsheet. And when you go to the script editor for the first time, or if you have the welcome screen still displayed, you may have to close out of it to come to the script editor here. So as mentioned before, I'll just copy and paste this code, just a few lines here. And I'll replace the sort of the stub that we give you. We'll save it. We'll call it custom menus. And it's ready to go at this point. So you can see that the lines actually the code is actually pretty straightforward. We'll kind of break this down in a second. But let's just make sure that we know what we're trying to achieve here. So here's the menu bar. And the goal of this exercise at the end is to be able to have your own menu logic associated in this bar. Okay? So we're going to go in here. And for this demo, we're going to manually run the onOpen function. So that's going to run this. And let's go ahead and I'll actually reload. There it is. And I'll reload this page real quick. And the onOpen should run. So it gives a special meaning to that function. And there it is. Now when I go ahead and say hi, that's going to run the function, and all it's doing at this point is showing a dialog saying hi. And as you can imagine, the other one says hello. Not very creative, but gets you the setup necessary to add your own custom menus. Now let's go take a look at the code real quick. And you saw that the onOpen had special meaning, and when I refresh the spreadsheet, I didn't have to run anything manually. It just ran by itself after a few seconds, after a check for the existence of the script. And what it is essentially a set of objects in an array. So this right here is a JavaScript object. It's a map. It's got a name and a value. The value is the important part here. This is the literal name of the function without any parameters. So you don't have to put the open close parentheses there. That's very important. I've seen a few people make that mistake. And the capitalization is also important. Function, capital, and name. And that's really it. And you can add any number of menus you want. In this example, like I said, all we're doing is show a dialog. But you could have your own custom calculation, your other business processes or workflows that you can have in JavaScript all can be injected in here. As a simple addition to something that you can do that's beyond what's in the tutorial, one of the things that we can do actually, and you may see this in other menus that we have, is that we have this concept of a separator in a few of these tutorials, in a few of these menus, I should say. So as a little pro tip, I can just inject null. And now when I run this method, go in here, and there's the separator between the two menu options. So that's a little nice thing that you can do to really lay out your menus the way you want to. And you can have multiple menus as well, right? So this ss.addMenu, you can have multiple calls of this, and it'll just stack left to right in the order you call it. So hope you found this useful. Take this tutorial and start building your own complex business processes and interesting things that you can do with your workflow, with your spreadsheets. Thank you.